My name is Mark Herman. I'm an assistant professor of medicine at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and Harvard Medical School, and we are here in my office. My lab is a lab in the Division of Endocrinology at Beth Israel, and it's a division that has a long history of very strong basic science research in metabolism. And metabolism-related diseases like diabetes and obesity. So I grew up in Texas, grew up in Houston. My interest in research probably goes back to my grandparents. Both of my grandfathers were kind of self-taught engineers, and both developed businesses based on various engineering principles. And I think it was really through their influence that I got very interested in how things worked, and the mechanisms, the processes by which machines did what they did. And I guess as an engineer, I want to take technologies and knowledge and apply them to the human condition very directly. So endocrinology, which is what I pursue, study of hormones and their effects on systems, led me here to Boston. Now I spend my days thinking about these interesting problems and figuring out how we can discover how our body works, how our body's metabolism really works, and try to figure out how we can help people lose weight, prevent these terrible diseases, which really are at epidemic levels in our population. There are an infinite number of unsolved problems. Every time we make a significant step forward, honestly, that opens the door to 100 more possibilities for things we hadn't considered before and new avenues. So it never ends, which is great. Yeah. We're studying the molecular processes by which different diets and nutrients interact with genes to cause metabolic diseases like obesity, hypertension, diabetes, cardiovascular disease. To get at that, we use genetic engineering methods to change the function of specific genes and then test how those genes now interact with different diets to cause these problems. So there are a number of direct applications of the research we do. Ultimately, we hope that the molecular insights we generate can be used to help diagnose, prevent, treat the development of these diseases. So as an example, through some of our molecular studies, we discovered that there was a hormone that was responding specifically to fructose ingestion. So there had never been any hormone that had been identified that specifically responded to fructose. And that allows us for the first time to characterize in individuals their individual responses to fructose ingestion. And lo and behold, the first time we did this in a set of 10 people, we saw dramatic differences in individuals' metabolic responses to fructose ingestion. And there was no way to even assess that before we found these mechanisms in model systems. And that means that if we can learn to manipulate these systems and the model systems, it provides possible treatments that we can apply to people to change how their body is metabolizing fructose and change the possible adverse effects related to fructose ingestion. I think I was always good at finding those avenues where I could do this kind of thinking and this work. Now, it's not to say that I think I could have done this kind of thinking in many, many disciplines. Research is probably not the only one, but it is a great one.